Nope, we just started actually, 5 o'clock. So, like I said before, I don't always have the ability to stream on Saturdays or Sundays, but today I have the ability, so that's exactly what I'm going to be doing. I was going to mention something else. Yes, it is live stream month, so the idea is to live stream every single day. I just can't guarantee Saturdays or Sundays, but I'll make an effort. But you know, sometimes there's just the things that do get in the way, and I can't stream. Razzle Frazzle was crying on her stream. I guess I shouldn't have. Missed that? Could have gotten a bag of popcorn. I don't know. Hope it wasn't for anything bad. That would not be nice. Good. Should be okay. There's a cutie pie in the corner over there. That's just trash. A big box of trash. Ah, okay. Well, thank you, Tetsui. Nostril funness. Alright, let's see, what are we going to do? To start the stream, we're going to do a little bit of a critique corner, which is something we haven't done in a while. If you don't know what critique corner is, it is when you send me a picture that you drew and you would like me to critique in front of everybody. If you don't want me to mention who drew it, that's perfectly fine, just tell me. And it's just for a chance that we can all kind of learn together whilst we're critiquing this picture. I'm mostly going to focus on anatomy, not really going to worry too much about the style because everybody has a different style, and I really don't want to change your style that you're going for. So if you do want to send a critique, just send me an email to my email. It is borntodie@hotmail.com. If you don't know my email is down there in the channel description. Make sure that you put the subject as critique or please critique, and then we'll check it out. And that's actually something I've done before on my other live stream. I did it on livestream.com. We did a couple of critiques and I think people enjoyed it, so hopefully I can do that here too. Let's see. Hello, Stargate nerd. Just a friendly warning that I will not be saving any of the changes or doodles that I do over your picture. You just have to pay attention and then try to replicate it yourself. This is not a chance for you to get free pictures from me. That's what I'm trying to say. Use it as a chance to learn and to improve yourself. Okay, it's not a way to get free stuff from me. Wow, music just cut out there for a second. So yes, please send me an email to my email to born to die at hotmail.com. Remember that these are zeros and the subject will be please critique. I think that's how you spell it. And then we'll get started and we'll do a couple little critiques and I hope you guys enjoy it. Let's see. Sargon is asking me if I actually remember him. I'm sorry, I do not, because everybody keeps changing their names. I don't keep track of people's names from the internet. It changes constantly. And also they keep changing their avatars and things like that, so... I'm sorry, man. I can't remember everybody. I have a hard time remembering the names of some of my students, so... You're gonna have to... You're gonna have to stand out more. See, Stargate ate a sandwich in one of my first streams. Alright. Was it a good sandwich? Because if it was a good sandwich, then awesome. My mouse is acting up. Ugh, my frickin' mouse. Hello, Art of Yordan. Welcome. I hope you don't take any offense, Stargate nerd. It's really difficult to remember somebody when you've never seen their face. Oh, that's good. Alright, so we're doing Critiquing Corner. Let us check my email. I have not gotten a single critique, so I guess you guys don't want me to critique anything. Okay. That's fine. Alright, we got one critique, so let's check it out. Remember, don't send me anything that you don't want me to show to everybody, okay? Also keep the files as small as possible. Don't send me super gigantic pictures, because it takes a long time to download. Hmm. Somebody just followed me. Thank you, Stargate Nerd, for following me here on Pictaro. I keep calling it Pictaro, but it's actually pronounced Picarto. Alright, so I got two critiques. I guess we'll work with those. Yes, that is correct. That is my email. Let's see. Well, let's see. All right. Let's check out some of the critique pictures that we got. I'll leave this up here just in case. Where did I leave that from? Okay, this picture is a little bit not safe for work, so you have been warned. Then again, this is a hentai. The next picture here is another picture that we got for the Critique Corner. First things first, let's lower the opacity, put a layer on top. Okay, change the color, that should be fine. Okay. Ablemind wants a bit of help when it comes to shading. That's always something to do. Let's see, okay, so the person wants me to talk about shading. We'll do that. Just a very quick rundown of the anatomy. I think the face is perfectly fine. Just eyeballing it, I think it's okay. Be careful with the definition of the ear. It just looks like there's a little hole on the side of her face. remember that ears have wrinkles and things like that. So if you want to show the ear, then show it. But if you don't want to show it, don't have it half shown if it's not necessary. Remember, you're the artist. You get to decide what you want to hide and what you want to show. So make sure you keep that in mind whenever you're drawing. Be decisive on what you want to show and what you don't want to show. Those for the ears would be. Okay, I'll just draw the face here so it doesn't look weird when I do the complete thing. Eyes are very kind of flat here, but very rounded here. Nice big smile. Alright, let's check the neck. Okay, correct. You did those little lines here. Then you put a little bump for the elbows. That's good. She's looking straight forward, so it should be relatively easy to do here. I think her shoulders are a little too wide for this character, mostly because the character is a very thin character. I think we can give her a little more feminine look if we just keep her frame compact. That's what's important. Okay. Don't be afraid to give this skinny character more definition when it comes to bumps and muscles and things like that, because the character is very skinny. More of the bumps and ridges, and especially the collarbone, is going to show because the character is very, very thin. Okay. Remember that the collarbone starts at the very beginning, so these bumps are very, very close to each other. Here you put the bumps very, very far apart. Keep them a little bit closer. Mm-hmm. Let's
breath here.
It's okay here. Almost no breath, that's fine. She's got a very long torso. Oh, the feet are fine. That's perfectly fine. Let's see here. Okay, this is where the shoulder is. Then the armpit would start a little bit lower than what you originally drew it. Young Cretiart wants to ask what the name of the song that is be playing. It is Through the Fire and Flames by Dragon Force. I think the arms that you've drawn here are a little too long for this character. This arm is perfectly fine. This is way too long. Let's take a look. If you take your fingers, your thumb and your pointing finger, and just place it where the shoulder starts and where the elbow ends, and lock your fingers like I did, and then do the exact same thing for the other one, you will notice that the shoulder and the elbow are way too long on the left arm. Right? So that's a good way to keep track of it. If you're having difficulty of how long an arm should be and the character is very flat, just use your fingers. Alright, so this is where the elbow would be. I think the arm that you drew here is very nice. Each finger is a different length, so that's very good. Nice rounded fingers, everything's very nice. I think this is okay. Everything else is fine. The knife is perfectly fine. Yeah, don't make your names overly bright. Then nobody can read it. Okay. The dress is okay. Just requires a little bit more detail here and there when it comes to folds and things like that. I don't think these folds are necessary because this part of the dress is very tight. So if there are any lines, it would be right here. That's where most of the wrinkles would start. Here's perfect one. I like this line that you drew here because it's being stretched from the chest. Okay, we can take this out because it's being hidden from the dress. I think I should draw up a hair. This cut. Nice hair shine. I like how you did the little shinies for the hair. And the ear would be hidden. Let's just hide the ear. It's not necessary to show it. Sometimes the most basic thing you can think of is sometimes the best because you don't overcomplicate the picture. You just get it done. Sometimes cel shaded looks the best compared to other really complicated shading techniques. This damn mouse. Uh, Alright, this person wants me to critique a little bit of the shading. That's exactly what we're gonna do. Let's see, change the canvas size. 200. Move this to the right, move this to the left. Ah, the smiles. Let's see. Alright, I'm going to show you a very quick placement of really, really dark shadows. Alright, so here you have let's see, here you place the shadows very correctly, but I think you have these really, really strong shading here, but you don't commit to any other shadows around here. You just kind of place them half-heartedly. For example, here you have really strong shadow here, which is correct because it's being hidden from the knife, but here you don't have anything there. And I would suggest, if you're having difficulty with shading, select one style. If you're going to do everything kind of airbrushed looking, then do that. Make everything airbrushed. Make everything nice and smooth. If you're going to do a cel-shaded look to it, then commit to being cel-shaded. Just make those lines and commit to those shadows. For example, here we have, let's put that under. We have a shadow here, and we fill it up. Oops. There you go. Yes. Where else would you find shadows? Right here, underneath the eyelashes. Ooh, I forgot to draw the eyebrows. That she looks evil. Let's see. Let's see here. Oh. Oops. Where else would you find shadows? Under the hair. Right here. The hair that you drew on this character is very, very flat. That's not a bad thing. It just means that shadows aren't completely necessary. I think the hair that you drew here is perfectly fine, at least for the shading. You don't need a whole lot of shadows. You did make the hair on the back darker, which is fine. That is what I would do. Make this part nice and dark here. You don't need a whole lot of shadows here. Just a couple of lines here and there, because the shading is quite flat. Okay. Now, it all depends on just how strongly lit do you want your character to be. If there is a very strong light lighting your character, then there's going to be a whole lot of shadows. When you draw characters that are outside in natural light, when it's like in the afternoon, there's a whole lot of sun, then there's going to be a crap ton of shadows. But if they're in a bedroom, and the bedroom is very, very soft lighting, then you can have very, very minimal, harsh shadows, and just focus on the tone of the skin. And, for example, if you want to have as many shadows as possible with hard light, we'll put some shadows here under the collarbone. Down the armpits as well. Also, because there's a little bit of bit here in the armpits. There's a whole lot of places that you can put shadows. I don't like to put really harsh shadows on some of the pictures because it's too overwhelming for a lot of pictures and it's not necessary. I want the character to really look bright and shiny. But if you really want to work with shadows, I'm not an expert on that, but you can try if you like. What will help you out is spheres and cylinders. Okay. So we have a sphere. Where is the light coming from? The light is coming from this side. That's the sun. So there's going to be shadow down here. Bam, real quick. How do I place this in the picture? Well, the face is a sphere. And the shadow and the light is coming from this side too. Let's see. The better the artist, the less shadows he needs. That does not make sense, man. Sorry, Boo Boo. That really doesn't make sense. It all depends on what you want the mood to be. If it's a very somber picture, then there's gonna be a crap ton of shadows. If it's a very bright, happy-go-lucky picture, then there's gonna be less shadows, but you're still gonna need a lot of shadows for lots of little things. It depends on the lighting. Thank you very much. Good line art. Make it three-dimensional without shading. Please show me a picture, Boo Boo. I would love to see that. Give me some. Okay, so so there's a whole lot of spheres and a whole lot of cylinders here placed in the fa here in the body. You have a sphere right here. I think I made a mistake. So if you wanted to, you can make shadows here. You can place shadows here because it is a cylinder. You could also place shadows here where the breasts are, and then continue. It all depends on just how much shadow and how the lighting is of your picture. Same thing with the dress and everything. For example, if the lighting is coming from this side, then there's gonna be shadow here. And here, if there's sun up here, then there wouldn't be no shadow there. It would just be here. And the cylinder refers to the arm. So you can have those kind of shadings if you want. I don't really like to do this because I don't like my shadows to be all that harsh. But there you go. Very quick like. And of course there's shadow beneath the dress. There. And this leg is being hidden in the background, so I will put a bit more shadow here. Because this leg is covering the leg on the back. So there's gonna be much more shadow down there. And here you really need to get creative with fabric. Adding different types of shadows here and there. It all depends on the fabric that you're using. There'll be a little bit of shadows here, just because there's a bit of wrinkles. Some shading there, some shading there. It all really depends on just how much shading do you want your character to have. Okay. Well, that's it. I hope that helped with a little bit of shading. If you have any questions, please let me know. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it, Abelmon. Mouse. Naoni is not digging this metal so much. Well, guess what? Everybody has different tastes. We'll see what we can do for next things. If you want, I can just turn off all music, but you guys listen to your own music. Oh yeah, baby metal. Mm. That's why, I mean, a lot of streamers like to put, you know, music while they're drawing, things like that. But they can listen to their music without putting it on the stream. So I could do that. I could just listen to my own music, and the only thing that you'll be listening to is my voice, and you guys can listen to whatever music you guys want. Would that be okay? Would you enjoy that? Let's check out the link. I'm not sure what you mean. It looks incredibly flat to me. I don't know what you're trying to tell me, boo-boo. I'm sorry. I'm trying to understand what you're telling me, but... I think the problem that I have is mostly that you refer to the better the artist, the less shadows. What makes one artist better than the other? Is it style? Is it the amount of detail? Is it movement? It's art. There is no better, really. I mean... Like, I keep using the example of Adventure Time. Adventure Time is freaking awesome stylistically. And I just love the way that the characters are drawn. They have a whole lot of movement to them. And they're very simple, but they're very easy to identify. It's all really, really nice. And then you have other cartoons where the characters are incredibly detailed. And it doesn't do anything for me. In some aspects, it's all aesthetics, and it's all different people have different opinions on this. So, I'm not sure what you're trying to say. I'm not saying that you need to have shadows in your pictures to make it a good picture. That's not what I'm saying. You can have a completely flat looking picture with characters, and it would look freaking awesome if you know what you're doing, of course. Yes, the reason you use shadows is to make things look three-dimensional. That doesn't mean it's better. I love 2D artwork, it's awesome. Wait, I should know what you mean when you say better? Come on, baby. Okay, well. Alright, well, enough of that. Go ahead, you guys. You can choose whatever you want. Let's see. Just one more metal song, we'll do something with a little bit more beat to it. They can't stop us, let 'em try. For heavy metal, we will die. see, we got a new... Thank you, Sue to you. Sue to you too, for following. We got a couple of more critiques. Let's see. The first time was first come, first serve. Now we're going to do whichever I feel deserves some critiquing love. Because... I should really get into some other types of drawing. the Pinkie Pie picture is very, very well done. I don't think you need my critique. But thank you for the picture, I guess. I'm sorry, Naomi, we're not gonna do that. But I'm glad you thought of it. Let's see... Zeraniac? You sent me an email, but no image was sent. I didn't receive an image, so I'm sorry. We got a trap picture here. I think I'm gonna focus on this one. Let's see. Okay guys, this is the last critique of the day, so don't send me any more critiques. We'll do another critique corner next stream, or next stream, whenever I decide, so you need to be here in my live stream in order to get an opportunity to get something critiqued. So don't forget to follow me, and you will be notified whenever I go live. Bye-bye, Tatsuing. Yes, Zeraniac. I didn't get a picture. Well, I didn't see a picture attached to it. I would suggest a Cintiq and not a Microsoft Surface, because the Cintiq is made specifically for drawing stuff. And the Surface is just a touchpad. Not that many things an artist. It is quite intimate. This is where my understanding of muscle is going to fall apart very, very quickly. We expect professionals and teaks used in video game companies and things like that are really freaking expensive. But it's for a company, so I'm sure they can afford it. What part of the drawing process do you like the most? Sketching, shading, coloring, etc. I like when I'm done. That's the best part, when I'm done. Once it's done and I did something good, that's the best part of drawing. Yeah. Saying that, I swear we're almost done, you guys. Sue to you too? Yes, and yes. see. Let us make the shadows stronger. Yeah, this needs stronger shadows. In order to keep the lines and the color, I use the option clipping group on top of where I put all the colors. All the colors are in this little folder to the right. The shading is on top, and I use clipping group so it will not leave the base color did. And you can do the same thing for any layer on top of that. Yes, clipping group keeps the color inside. Well, there you go. See, my streams aren't a complete waste of time. Sometimes. Big shiny butt. You gotta be oiled up for a pageant. Nah, I gotta do them again. Let's try that one more time. It is particularly shiny. It'll start.
Flash it, Kimmel, upgrade it, charge it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work it, quick erase it, write it, cut it, paste it, save it, load it, check it, quick rewrite it, plug it, play it, burn it, rip it, drag it, drop it, zip, unzip it, lock it, fill it, curl it, find it, view it, code it, jump, unlock it, suppose it, reach it, bring it, pay it, watch it, turn it, leave it, start, format it, buy it, use it, break it, fix it, trash it, change it, mail, upgrade it, charge it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work it, quick, erase it, write it, cut it, paste it, save it, load it, check it, quick, rewrite it, plug it, play it, burn it, rip it, drag it, drop it, zip, lock it, and find it, it's fixed, grow it, poise it, pick it, cross it, crack it, twitch, update it, name it, read it, tune it, print it, scan it, send it, fax, rename it, touch it, bring it, pay it, watch it, turn it, leave it, start, format it. Technologic. 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 Buy it, use it, break it, fix it, crash it, turn it, uncharge it, press it, crack, get it, paste it, save it, load it, check it.
Just because the song is old doesn't mean it's bad.
Turn it, Technologic. 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 Technologic.
Yep, we're almost done. This is the last thing we're going to do for this stream. Then we're going to call it a night. Yep, the grand finale. Jeez, 4 in the morning. Right now it is 8:33 in the PM down here in good old Mexico. Totally for you guys. I'm gonna get these eyes just right. In Brazil. Z. Yeah, no background. I don't think it's necessary. Kind of like the little darker tone to it, like that. That song. I think we are done. Yep, there's nothing else I can do. I'm done. Took longer than I expected. That's fine. Yes, so there you go. This picture is the Pixiv account. Probably not DeviantArt for obvious reasons. But you can check out my Pixiv account in the channel description. You will find it. Just scroll down and you'll find the two links. Of course, be warned, it is extremely not safe for work. If you don't know what that means, then you're not old enough to go there. And please don't forget to follow me here on Picarto and check out all my DeviantArt. Also check out my YouTube account. I don't think I have the link down in the channel description yet. But then again, I don't have that much. That many videos in my YouTube channel just yet. I do have a couple of tutorials. They're kind of old, but they have some of the basic things down there. I do have play of sitting down and things about it. Don't forget to also check out my Steam account. I think they have the zeros again. Yes, check out my Steam account. And this morning I played Metal Slug with someone from the chat. Maybe think is it. Thank you so much for checking out my stream. I hope you enjoyed it. And tomorrow, I'm not really sure if I'm going to do it. Probably not. But we will return on Monday, 5 o'clock, and we will continue with the whole stream.